In this video, we're going to take a look at how we can track our medications we're taking with the iPhone. We do this through the Health app. Not only can we track our medications, but we can also see if there are any interactions between the medications we're taking or with alcohol, tobacco, or even cannabis. Now, if you like this video, stick around to the end. I'll tell you a little bit more about myself and how you can help support my efforts in creating these videos. All right, let's take a look at how we track our medications on the iPhone. Let's go over to my iPhone. Now, as I mentioned in the introduction, this is all done through the Health app. So let's go ahead and open up my Health app here. Now, what we need to do is we need to go over to Browse, the Browse tab in the lower right-hand corner. Under Browse, you're going to see Medications. This is where we can set up what medications we want to track. I tap on it, and now we can start adding our medications. But before we do that, there's a few options that I recommend people go through. So I'm going to swipe up here. The first thing is, what I would recommend doing is connecting this to your health provider. When you connect it to your health provider, what they will do when there's an update is they'll be able to send it to your health app. So then you can easily add any medications that you're taking. They'll be able to update that for you. All you do is just tap on Get Started here, and you go and search for your provider. So Holland Hospital is our local hospital. I just tap on that, and then I would add that account. I also use Trinity, so I'm going to go back, and I can type in here Trinity. Trinity Health of Michigan, I can go and add that account. We can't add more than one account. And then I also use Corewell, so I can go and add them as well. Now, this is my demo iPhone, so I don't actually have them connected, but on my personal iPhone, I do have all three of these connected. So as they update my records, I'm able to see it in the Health app, and I'm able to add any medications easily as they add them to my charts. So I'm going to cancel here. So if you can, set up your medication records. Now, not everyone can do this. There are some providers that don't connect up to the Health app yet. So you may not be able to do this, but it's not a big deal. You can still add the manual, as you'll see shortly. So that's the first thing. Add your medication records from your provider. The next thing that I recommend is pinning this to the summary. When you tap on this, what it's going to do is it's going to move it into the summary tab. So I tap on it. Now it's pinned to the summary, and when I go over here to summary, you're going to see I have medications here. I think of the summary tab as kind of like our home. This is where we can go and set, when I tap on edit here, I can go and set what I want to see in the Health app. So basically, I just added medications to that. So that's the second thing. The next thing is I'd like to recommend you set up your notifications. So I'm going to tap on medications again. And then when we go down to the very bottom, you're going to see options. I tap on options, and then from here I can set up my reminders. By default, dose reminders is turned on. So basically, when we add a medication, again, you'll see this shortly, what you can do is you can set a time that you need to set that medication. So let's just say it's 9 in the morning. What the iPhone will then do is remind you at 9 in the morning to take that medication. Now, let's say you missed that notification. Well, what you can also do is set up follow-up reminders. So I recommend turning this on. When this is turned on and you don't track that medication, let's say you take a medication at 9 o'clock in the morning, you didn't take it, you didn't track it. What this will do is this will send a follow-up reminder 30 minutes later saying, hey, did you take your medication? Would you like to track it? So I like to leave that on or turn that on as well. And then we have time zone change. When you're going into a different time zone, what this will do is this will change the alerts to the appropriate time zone. So I recommend turning all of these on. Now we can go back to our medications and we can start adding our medications. We've got it all set up. How do we do that? Well, we just go back to the top and you're going to see add a medication. I take Imitrex for migraines. So let's just go ahead and add that in there. So I tap on it. And then from here, I just search. Tap on search. It is a database. So you just start typing and then you're going to see Imitrex here. Tap on it. And this is not a nasal spray that I take. So what I need to do is I need to show more. This is a capsule that I take. So now I just tap on capsule and tap on next, and I add the strength. These are 50 milligrams. I'm going to type in here 50 milligrams. Make sure that I select milligrams in there. And now I tap on next. Next thing is a schedule. Well, I take these as needed. I don't take them every day. So I don't want to have this say every day. I don't want to have a reminder. So I tap on change here and I just go as needed. And then I tap on next. I choose the shape. It is this shape here. Next, tap on the color. This makes it easy to identify. Tap on next. And then I can add any optional details. I'm not going to make any changes, so we just go to done here. And I've just added that medication. We can see it here. Now, this is as needed. What about medication that you need to take on a regular basis? Let's go and add aspirin. Maybe I take aspirin every morning. So I go again to add medication. I'm going to search for aspirin. And we have aspirin up here at the top. This is a tablet, so I'm going to swipe up here and you're going to see it says tablet here. Next, what is the strength? Well, this is just 81 milligrams, just a low dose. And when do I take it? And we're just going to leave this as every day. From here, I go and add at what time and how often. So the first one is going to be at 9 a.m. So I just go in here and go to 9 a.m. And I can set how many I take at 9 a.m. And then if I want to add a second time, I can do that as well. So maybe I have to take another one at 3 p.m. I'm just going to leave it at 1. And then the last step here is, what is the duration? Well, this is going to be ongoing, so I'm just going to leave this as none for the end date. But you can tap on this and add an end date as well. So if it's just a temporary medication, you can do that as well. I tap on next. We go through the shape and the colors. I can go and add any optional information in here. I tap on done. And now we have my two medications here. So that's how easy it is. Now, as I take Imitrex, this will be as needed. And this one here, the aspirin, will alert me every day at 9 a.m. And if I don't get that alert or if I don't indicate that I took it, it'll follow up with another reminder 30 minutes later. So that's basically all we have to do. So now let's just log a couple of these. Let's say that I need to log my aspirin. I tap on it. You're going to see I have today's log. I just tap on that, saying that I took the medication. And when I tap on done, we can see that I took that medication today. Now, as you take these medications through time, what you're able to see up at the top here is a daily view, a weekly view, a monthly view, a six-month view, as well as an annual view. So you'll be able to see any trends or anything like that and see how often you took that medication. I swipe up. I can also see when it was logged, and I can make any changes to it. I can change the schedule. I can read about aspirin here. And then if I want to see if there's any drug interactions, I can do that as well. You're going to see that I do have a drug interaction here. So I tap on it, and I go and select my current factors. This is where we can set if we drink alcohol, take cannabis, or tobacco. I don't smoke, but I do take cannabis to help me sleep, and I do drink alcohol. So I'm going to leave those two on and turn off tobacco, or leave tobacco off. And now, what I'm able to see is any critical interactions. Good thing I don't have any critical interactions, but there is a serious interaction between alcohol and aspirin. And if you want to read more about it, you tap on that, you can read more about it, and then you can consult your doctor about it. And then we also have moderate interactions. I go back. Let's go and take a look at Imitrex. Let's say that I have a migraine, so I need to log Imitrex here. I tap on it, and then I just go and log that. I've taken the Imitrex, tap on done. it's a bad migraine. When it's a really bad migraine, sometimes I take two. So I can go back in here and log a new dose. And when we do that, you're going to see that it went to two. And again, I'd be able to see any trends. I could share this with my doctor or show this to my doctor, and we'd be able to figure out if there are any trends with my migraines. I can see if there are any interactions by swiping up. Looks like I don't have any interactions, but we do have side effects here, or I could possibly have side effects. There are no side effects. At least there's no information, but depending on the medication that you take, you'll be able to see if there's any side effects as well. And again, I don't have any interactions with this. I go back. If you take a lot of medications, and when we swipe up here, you can also see all of your interactions. You can see that I just have one here. So we can see it when we're looking at a specific medication, and we can see it between all of our different medications, the interactions. Now, in addition to that, what we're also able to do is export our medications that we've taken as a PDF. Maybe you want to share this with a doctor. How do you do that? Well, we go back to all of our medications here. So I'm looking at all of my different medications. I swipe up, we can see my medications. But when we go down to the bottom, we're going to have an option here for export PDF. When I tap on that, what I'm able to do is see all the medications that I've taken. And if I wanted to share this, maybe I want to print this or I want to put this into a note, you just tap on the share icon. And then from here, if you have a printer connected to your network, you're able to print it. Or what you can do is you can share this to a note, or you could even email it. Basically, just sharing that PDF. Now, when you're done with the medication, what you're also able to do is archive it or delete it. What I would recommend doing is just archiving it, so then you still have record of it. So how do we do that? Well, we go into the medication. So let's say I'm done taking aspirin here. I no longer need to take that. When I tap on it and we go down to the bottom, what you're going to see is archive. I tap on that and I can go and archive that. Now, if you just want to delete it all together, you can do that as well. You're going to see delete down at the bottom. So that is how we can track our medications on the iPhone. Again, this is all done through the Health app. Not only can we track our medications that were taken, we can get reminders to remind us to take that medication, and we can see if there are any interactions between the different medications we're taking, as well as between alcohol, cannabis, and tobacco. Just go into the Health app, go to Browse, and you'll see medications there. From there, you just need to go and start adding your medications. So that's how we can track our medications on the iPhone. Now, if you found this video helpful, what you may want to do is like the video, subscribe to my channel, or you could share it with your friends and family. In addition to that, what you may want to do is check out danstutorials.com. Not only do I have more videos there, but I also have an AI assistant modeled after an Apple Genius, and I host webinars and classes on a regular basis. So how can you help support my efforts in creating these videos? It is a membership-based site. When you become a member, I will take out all of the ads of the videos for you. You have access to that AI assistant modeled after an Apple Genius, and you have access to my classes and webinars. Also, you are helping support a small business. It is just me in a corner office of my house. I'm not part of some large organization. So when you become a member, you are directly supporting my efforts in creating these videos. Check out danstutorials.com for more information, and thanks for watching.